Value and you move from one place to another. The term sporkin in Russian, a piece cut from clothing, we used in some endowments, for example, the endowments by Prince Siviani Bolesman, by some people, citizens, for example, Victoria Rusinum and others. For example, like this felonium sewn from pieces of women's clothing paper. And we see the second use of the decoration part of the costume. So, in the rural costume, in the rural dress, in the main studied by the burials, the sewn endowments are the metal pendants of different forms. The sewn pendants are the metal chains, bands, pendants in the form of miniature tools, zoomorphic, and etc. The pendants were suspended on the wings or sewn on the eyelids. Besides the pendants, the beads from glass and metal, separate rings, drilled bones, and small plaques and spirals are also used as a sewn decoration. And this, in this picture, some types of the old dress suspension brackets. For example, the chain. Another chains, bronze and iron. The bronze belts on the wire rings. Zoomorphic bronze suspension brackets and the bronze shining suspension brackets. Trapezoidal pendants, pendant in the form of finger ring, metal tube with ruler cord, spiral sewn ornaments. So there are some questions about these ornaments. First of all, how these categories of ornamentation were attached to the cloth, directly to the cloth, or to the removal by removing apron and tails of the costume. Which part of the costume were decorated? How these clothes were used? More often, we think that they are sewn directly on the clothes. This variance of wearing is often used in the costume reconstruction of Olgun's costume. I think perhaps this is just one way. Sewing of jewelry on the clothes entails certain difficulties in its washing, bracing, wearing, as well as damage. I think it is possible that a dress with a lot of metal ornaments, festive and used rarely, in the first case. In the second case, except the sewing of the clothing, we have some other variants of attaching of the ornamentation to the cloth. For example, also woolen or leather cords, like at this picture. The cord attached to the belt or in the shoulder and wrist zone of the costume. And so we see the bronze belts on the wooden cords on the belt. For example, on the leather details. There are some files of leather fragments together with the chains and rings, separate rings, and pendants on the rings. Perhaps it was a base for attachment of metal pendants. Some of them look like the remains of the dress, like these fragments with the perforation. And probably with the straps, with the bronze chains. The location of the adornments for the burials gives some more information about their role in the dress codes. Whereas some burials give the clues or so ornamentation placed in a certain order. There are some variants of this. For example, the roles of the belts on the shoulder, wrist, and belzone. Sometimes on the pole. And in this case, we see the rows, bell rows, and the first three, first resume, it was a white pipeline. It's a question. In other case, the rows of the bells is the zone of spirit. The emerald, it's a question. The rows of the soul plates in the wrist and bells zone. Is the white headline? Probably. The rows of the bells. The bells in the song of skirt, the apron, probably. The rose of the song purpose is a priest and the song. Probably the white marks the white neckline. Another order is the rose of the song, is the, I'm sorry, the red symmetric bells. And other types of pendants on the shoulder. Probably they mark the strips of the shoulder. Probably the order of the sword generally can mark the places of the cut, the seam, and the edges of the clothes. The most possible. The edges and the juncture of the separate details of the cut and decorated details. Probably the stripes, the white neckline, and some colors. Sometimes the rings, these dependents, can be not only the decoration. I think they can be the question. We can fasten the details of the cut by the sewer or on quest. So it on or pressed into the of Fremont's book style. Thank you very much.